A lot of the times we think about democracy and we bemoan the fact that the U.S. has pitiful levels of voter turnout compared to other countries. Very few people vote here, say compared to Denmark, right, where you have upwards of 80% of people voting in elections. Here we have barely half the population voting in elections. And that seems pretty bad, especially when we pride ourselves on being this model democracy. What I'm talking about in the book is that democracy is more than just elections. And trying to get people to participate in politics involves more than just going to the voting booth. It really involves a kind of thick idea of democracy and all of the ways that people can make their voices heard in civil society or in kind of the area of voluntary organizations. You need to do more than just turn out and vote, right? You need to know what's going on. You need to be informed and engaged and educated. You need to think about how to send a message to a politician. A vote is a sloppy tool for sending a message because you have one vote and many issues. But it's also important to remember that if you want to change policy outcomes, if you want to make a difference, if you want to make government actually do something different, something that's more reflective of your views, then what I find in the book is actually this kind of protest, the civil society activity, is more effective in changing government action than trying to focus on, electing people who look like you. That's actually a very loose and unreliable mechanism for substantive representation of marginalized groups. And if we think that democracy is self-government, we have to be a lot more cognizant of all the different aspects of self-government that there are, including this kind of arena of civil society.